Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I have a kind of unique Dazzled or Disappointed for you. Not unique in that this is... Okay, it's kind of... Maybe it's not unique. I don't know what I'm talking about. But I say it's unique because I don't really like to... If something is already sold out and I don't know if it's coming back, it's harder for me to want to post a review online or on YouTube. But in this case, I feel like this thing has come in and out of stock so often that I'm not convinced it's not coming back in stock. So today I'm going to give you a real quick Dazzled or Disappointed on the Sephora and Moschino Teddy Bear Eyeshadow Palette. It is the only product that I picked up from the collection. It's the product I knew I wanted. I stalked that website so much that I thought, I better get my hands on this thing because it will all be for nothing if I don't. And so finally it released, 2 a.m., done. So I have used this quite a bit, and so I'm actually wearing it today. Even though I am wearing the glasses, I will show you up close here in just a little bit what the shades look like on my eyes, or the look that I did today. So I want to go ahead and give you swatches, thoughts, description, so that you know if this is worth the hype, because this thing has been all over. Like, I mean, I feel like it's so great. It caused so many uproars. People got so upset over this thing. It's kind of like the Anastasia subculture palette. It's like, okay, it's an eyeshadow palette. Granted, I am one of those people where I'm like, ah, I want to get my hands on it. But at the same time, people were really losing their minds over this. But anyways, so let's just go ahead, and that's my phone blowing up. I'm probably on some sort of group message. So I'm sorry for that, but let's just go ahead and jump right into this. Okay, my friends, so the box comes like this. Nothing super exciting. It's cute, though. It says, touch me. You remember how back in the day when we were kids, how, like, maybe they probably still have this now, but, like, they'd have a toy and it'd be like, touch me or push me, and it would sing, or, you know, just whatever. Anyways, I think that's a cute little touch, kind of bring back childhood memories. So the funny thing about the box, and I'm gonna have to show you the palette so that you have an idea. Okay, so the top, or the front of the bear, says, this is not a Moschino toy. And then the box on the side has a bear and it says, this is a Moschino eyeshadow palette. So very, very cute. I like the details on that. I don't know if there's anything else to tell you about the box. It's got kind of a description in the back. It says, the ultimate iconic eyeshadow palette. Contains 21 colors in matte satin and shimmer finishes inspired by the mood and feeling of Moschino. Since 2013, Jeremy Scott, the creative director behind Moschino, has created chic, covetable designs in fashion while maintaining his independent spirit. In partnership with Sephora, the Los Angeles-based designer now brings his design aesthetic to beauty like never before. When thinking about the collaboration with Sephora, I wanted to capture the iconography of Moschino, and there could be no more perfect of an ambassador to do that than our mascot teddy toy. Now introducing this limited edition collaboration that unites the playful essence of Moschino with the beauty expertise of Sephora. With an uptown or downtown vibe, each of these makeup essentials and travel-ready accessories features exclusive colors inspired by the mood and feeling of Moschino, only at Sephora. So this bad boy was $48. Comes in probably the cutest packaging you have ever seen in your life. I mean, this is, I wanted this just on the packaging alone. When it came in and I showed my husband, he was like, I see now why you wanted it. You wanted it because of the bear, because of the packaging. Who cares what's inside? But so, so cute. And you know, I love unique things like that. You can buy 100 palettes that are just the standard square that you open up, has the mirror, but things like this are so, so neat. So basically, you know, it's flat. You've probably seen a million videos and pictures of this little guy, but he opens up right here. He's got like a little clasp on the end. He opens up, it's got a mirror, and then you've got the eyeshadow palette. There are two, okay, I thought there were two. There's just one. There's a little groove right here. Hold on, let me tuck this in. Do these things ever get on your nerves, these hanger thingies? Sometimes I wonder, should I cut it off and then, like, if it slips off the hanger, I'm not gonna worry. But anyways, I don't know. I'll think about that another day. Okay, so it's got like a little groove right here where you can pop this thing out. at least I think you can. I have tried, and mine is very, very difficult, and I'm not looking to break it, and I'm really not looking to take it out of here. So there would not be a groove here for nothing. I know it's for you to pop it out. So just so you know that. The material, so the gold that surrounds the mirror, and then what surrounds the eyeshadows almost feels like a really heavy-duty cardboard. It might be plastic. It feels like one of those real thick foam cardboards. You know, like the Tarte Big Book of Shadows, how that top part is like a foamy, thick kind of cardboard. That's what that feels like. So right here you've got your 21 eyeshadows in an array of colors, in an array of finishes. So let's get to swatching because I am very excited to show these to you. First four are Adore, Pennies from Heaven, which, do I have any Cary Grant fans out there? Because wasn't there a Cary Grant movie called Pennies from Heaven? I love him. I love Cary Grant. I won't say I am a diehard fan that I know every movie he's been in. Obviously, I can't even remember if the title of this movie was called Pennies from Heaven. I think it was. Anyways, I do love some of his movies. Bound Brown and Fantasy. And that's what those look like right there. The next four are Fort Knox, Mesmerized, Clay, and Angel Wings. So you've got a good bit of crease colors in this palette. And that's what those look like. Notice how smooth they're going on. Not one has really looked patchy, and I have not really had to rub. That's really just with one swipe. Your next four are Fleur, Kisses, Prairie Flower, and Pixie Dust. So that purple one, which is that third one, is the first one that you're going to be able to see is a little bit patchy, not really as pigmented. Your next four are Moondust, Spun Gold, that's Moondust, then it's Palace, then it's Spun Gold, and then it's Magic. And Magic, I feel like, is almost gonna look a little olive green. It is the black. I accidentally dug my finger into this after having swatched this. Not super amazing on my part, but that's what those look like. So right there, and you can tell that black is a little bit patchy as well. But these are out of this world. Look how crazy pigmented those are. Especially those satin shimmer. I guess, you know, they're satin or shimmer. Let me see. Yeah, those are more of like a foiled kind of finish. Those are nice. I had five left, so I had to do the whole thumb thing. We've got Twilight Blue, Attitude, Barely Bare, Nightlife, and Deep Sea. I get a little crumbly. I feel like Lorac ones do that too when I think sometimes I dig a little too hard and pick up a little too much. Look at that duochrome. That one is so nice. I feel like there's so many shades now. Do you remember MAC Blue Brown Pigment? It was like so innovative. It was like the first of its kind, and I feel like there have been so many companies that have now tried to duplicate that. So you have a lot of, you know, dupes for that blue brown pigment, and that's what that reminds me of. Maybe not as strong, but in a way it really does remind me of that. So okay, let me wipe this off of my hand so I don't get this all over my dress, because, oh, we know that will happen. That's the story of my life. If there is something on me, I will get it on my clothes. If I am eating, it will end up somehow on my clothes. Story of my life. Okay, guys, so I have used this pretty much, I won't say every day since the day I got it, but most days from the day I got it. Now, you know Sephora has stepped up their game. Those Sephora Pro palettes that came out recently, the editorial, and then there was that cool and warm palette that was like $68, but that, you know, had a lot of people really, really impressed with the Sephora brand. Sephora has been stepping up their game, and I feel like this is no exception. A lot of times when the Sephora brand does a collaboration, it's not usually on par to what you would find with like a higher end brand as far as quality. And I just have never, there are some things I have liked about the Sephora collection in the past. Recently, I have been very impressed with their eyeshadows. I had purchased that editorial Sephora Pro palette. I did a review on that. It's on, if you're looking for a review on that, it is on my channel. But I had my reservations about this because it was going to be a collaboration. Because of the price tag, $48, it's not really too bad for how many shadows you're getting and for the packaging. So I thought, okay, we're going to have to wait and see what this looks like. This is kind of on par with their new formulation with the way they've stepped up their game. Now, let me zoom you in real quick and I will show you. I am so blind without my, and I don't mean that in a negative way. It's very difficult. I'm not farsighted. So let me just say, I'm not seeing very clear right now. Can see myself in the viewfinder, but I do want to show you what this looks like. So much easier when I wear my contacts. Okay, so this is what the eyeshadow looks like, and this is after pretty much a full day of wear. I have been wearing this since 6:30 this morning. It is now 6:30 in the evening, exactly, 6:29. So eyeshadow primer, I have been wearing this. Now the shade right here is Pennies from Heaven. That is one of my favorites. I apply it wet and it is stunning. These shimmer shades, they go on so foiled. Let me zoom you out because we are very close and personal right now. They go on so foiled when you wet your brush. They're already very pigmented and it just adds, just magnifies the color, the finish. I was so impressed, especially with those shimmer shades. So I am actually, let me see what I am wearing. I am wearing in my crease Mesmerized, which is this shade right here. Like I said, on most of my lid, I am wearing Pennies from Heaven. On the outer portion of my lid, I smoked it out with this Bound Brown shade. And then in my inner corner, which at this point in time, because it is the end of the day, is probably gone, was Angel Wings, which is this kind of shiny pinky baby pink shade. So definitely got to use several shades. I've used some of the other shades and they go on just as nicely. I will tell you, some of the mattes to the touch are a little bit chalky, powdery, feeling a little bit stiffer. I do not find that that has impacted the performance. With the exception of those two that I told you were a little bit more patchy, which were the this purple shade right here, which is called Prairie Flower, and then the black, which is called Magic. Those two do go on a little bit more patchy, a little bit drier. But for the most part, there's a couple others that also feel a little bit dry and stiff, and that does not translate onto my brush and onto my eye. They go on so nicely. I have found these matte shades to be incredibly blendable. I have not had really any issues. Usually you buy something like this and you're like, okay, the packaging's beautiful. I wasn't as crazy about the shadows, but that's okay. I'll put this as kind of like a decoration on my shelf and I'm good to go. Okay, this has been decoration on my shelf and I pick it up every day, practically every day, to use it because I have been so impressed with the eyeshadows. This is an absolute Dazzled for me. So I would say if you can find it, pick it up and don't hesitate. The thing about the Sephora email me notification is that it will email you a couple of hours after it's come back in stock. So at that point, if you have people stocking the Sephora website and placing their orders, it's very, very possible it will sell out before you even get the notification. And that's what makes people so mad. Hey, I just got the notification. How come it's already sold out again? That can't be possible. I literally just got the notification. That's why, is because I have signed up for the notification, yet I will still stock the site for certain things. And I'm like, oh, it's back in stock and I never got the notification. I will place my order. A couple hours later, I will get the email notification. Hey, guess what's back in stock? You better hurry before it sells out. So that's what frustrates people. And that's what makes it hard for me to really encourage using the email notification for something like this. I have found on Instagram, Trend Mood and G_Glow Beauty, I think. Anyways, I know it starts with a G_Glow. Between her and Trend Mood, if you will follow them on Instagram and turn on the post notifications. Literally every time this has come in stock, they've posted, hey, it's just come back into stock. So that really is the best way to pick something up when it's this hard to find. I suggest calling your local Sephora store. There's always the route of eBay, but I think they're selling for like a lot of money right now. So unless you want, I'm going to be absolutely honest with you, I would probably pay what they're going for on eBay right now. Like, I would pay, honestly, $80 or something. That would probably be like a lot of my makeup allowance for the month, but it's worth it. I'm just trying to make a point that this little guy right here is absolutely worth it. I loved it. I'm really, really impressed. Really, really happy with it. Yes, I absolutely recommend I Am Dazzled. All right, guys, let me give you real, real quick the verse of the day. It comes from 1 John 5:3, and it says, this is love for God, to obey his commands, and his commands are not burdensome. I know a lot of people say, oh, I don't want to do that because I don't have to like follow the Bible and it's boring. And it is so not boring. Trust me. There's every ounce of truth of that, in that his commands are not burdensome. I mean, if anything, you have someone to help bear your burdens, to be your best friend, to walk through life with you. He's so amazing. And so I just want to give you that encouragement, that verse of the day. I hope y'all are having a wonderful day. And I hope you'll consider subscribing if you have not already. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. And if you're looking to follow me on Instagram, you can find me at Michelle's Glamour. To all of my fellow Texas neighbors, if you are impacted, I am praying for you. You are heavy on my heart. I love each and every one of you. It's easy for me to say we're in this together when I am not as impacted as somebody who just lost everything. So you guys are in my thoughts and in my prayers. We're neighbors and I love my state. So I will see you guys very, very soon in the next video.